Monroe sailed on in darkness following the swan's voice, but he never saw a thing. Not the stars, not the swan, and certainly not the tree he got stuck in. When the clouds lifted, the swan was gone, leaving Monroe alone in the middle of an immense forest. Since there was nothing else to be done, he jumped. The king was tired of creating perfect kingdoms only to attract less than perfect subjects. He decided he'd have to leave a legacy the old-fashioned way, with a family. So he began to build one, starting with a house. The king had never had much luck with people, so instead of trying to find a wife, he painted one. When she opened her eyes, the king was astonished. He had created a female version of himself. The king was in love. Bursting with joy, the king locked himself in his workshop painting gifts for his queen. He never saw her lack of interest, though she made no effort to hide it. The only gift she kept was his first, a little silver paintbrush. Every day, the king painted a new room for the house, and every day he abandoned it as not good enough for his queen. While he slept, the queen spent her nights painting creatures of the forest, though she never finished a single one. 5 months went by before the king noticed she was pregnant.
Thank you.
On the night before the queen was to give birth, she left. All she took was a single, unfinished painting. When the king woke, he found no explanation, and he never did. The king didn't paint a thing. Then he had a vision, a colossal monument of himself that would be his legacy for the ages. But he hadn't even finished painting the scale model, which was over 100 feet tall itself, when his powers began to fail. Never finished another painting. Then one night he went to sleep and couldn't even finish his own dream, and he's been trapped inside it ever since. As Monroe stood there trying to think of something to say, the statue shuddered and the hatch slammed shut. And now there was no more need for talking. The king was awake.